This week on Maker Update, levitating water with LEDs, 3D printed skull buttons, the Maker's rechargeable battery, servos on Pi, a game of Twang, Arduino animatronics, and Project Talk with Becky Stern. I'm Donald Bell, and it's time for another Maker Update. I hope you're all doing well. I am still continuing to weld together my go-kart frame for the Power Racing series, but look, it's starting to look like a thing now. It's still not a go-kart, but it's getting there. I have a lot to talk about this week, so let's get started with the project of the week. This week, the Arduino blog introduced me to Isaac Chasteau, who created this amazing water fountain where the drops look like they're levitating or even floating up. The project uses a peristaltic pump to continuously move the water from the bottom to the top, a 3D printed funnel narrows the stream down a little, and there's a metal scouring pad down at the bottom to cut down on the dripping sound. The magic of the project, though, are these LED strips on the side of the fountain, which are set to strobe at just the right frequency to capture the phase of the water dropping, creating the illusion. Set a little slower, the water looks like it's dropping in slow motion. Set a little higher, the drops appear to float upwards. You can also have each color phase at a different rate to create cool effects. And Arduino Uno is driving the LEDs using code and a custom library that Isaac has over on GitHub. You can find all the links in the show notes. Another project that caught my eye this week were these 3D printed skull buttons by Micosaurus. The button itself is adorable and looks great printed out on this bone-colored filament. But what's extra great is how accessible the project is. Mike goes step by step through how he measured his original button and created this design in Tinkercad in addition to a bunch of prototypes that didn't work out. And of course, it doesn't have to be a skull, it could be whatever you want, but it's a great intro into working with Tinkercad and a fun, quick 3D print. It's time for another cool tool review. This time we're going to take a look at one of the most popular rechargeable batteries that most people know nothing about. It is the 18650 format lithium ion rechargeable battery. I got a pair of these on Amazon for about $9, although you can get sketchy no-name versions for a lot less than that. I'm going to tell you why they're awesome, and if you want to get some for yourself, you can use the Amazon link in the description, which helps support my videos and the Cool Tools blog. The 18650 battery is an extremely common lithium-ion rechargeable battery. We just don't normally see them because they're tucked away inside our electronics. I opened up a rechargeable drill recently and found one inside. There's one inside this solar emergency radio I have. I'm sure there's a bunch of others inside my house that I'm not even aware of. They're relatively cheap, easy to recharge, and they can store a lot of power compared to a rechargeable AA battery. What makes these great for electronic projects and cosplay lighting effects is that they spit out a 3.7 volts that's perfect for small project boards like the Teensy or Adafruit Trinket, Gemma, or Feather. It also turns out to be a good enough voltage for driving LED strip. So for example, I wanted to put some LEDs on my Power Racer to show it off at night. I glued in some LED strip and wired it up to a Gemma board. And to power it, I first used one of these flat LiPo packs. But it didn't hold much charge, and when it runs out, I either had to recharge it through the board over USB or swap it out by pulling this tiny connection. It wasn't worth it. As an alternative, I also tried running it off of AA batteries, which were easier to swap out, but drain just as fast. So far, using a single 18650 has worked the best. I bought a 10-pack of these holders on Amazon for around $7, wired one up and glued it in. With this, it runs for longer than I need, and a loop of gaffer tape around the battery makes it easy to pull out when I need to recharge. You do need to get a special charger. This one with a nice LCD cost me $16 on Amazon. It runs off USB. You can get cheaper ones without the screen. So that's my story with the 18650 rechargeable batteries. They're great for powering small project boards and LEDs, which are honestly the bread and butter of most Maker projects. Like any rechargeable battery though, you have to be careful not to puncture it or expose it to fire, so be careful. You can pick up the batteries, the holders, and the charger all using Amazon links in the description, and remember, you can see thousands of reader recommended tools like these at cool-tools.org. I've got time for a few more tips. First, be sure to check out the new issue of Hackspace magazine. It's got Sophie Wong, maker of the Raspberry Pi Selfie Bot, on the cover. She's showing off some of her NeoPixel fingernails. She's also inside with a cool Ghostbusters Proton Pack. You can download a PDF of the magazine for free. Matt from Raspberry Pi Spy has a great tutorial on how to get started using and controlling servos with the Raspberry Pi. There are sample Python scripts that you can copy and paste and a video walkthrough too. The Twang Joystick Project by Bart Dring is 2 years old, but it's new to me. It's a game that you play on a single strip of LEDs inspired by Line Wobbler by Robin B. It uses a doorstop spring as a controller, and there's a great playlist of videos showcasing how Bart developed the project and even mounted a playable version on the front of his house. What's new is that he's just started selling a kit for this project on Tindy with a custom board for connecting up the accelerometer, a speaker, and the LED strip. It seems like a great price for what he's made. Jim Lemus, the maker behind the amazing Talking Tiki Totem that I showed you back in episode 50, has a multi-part series on building an Arduino-based animatronic puppet. He's using an Adafruit feather and a servo feather wing to create a system that allows you to record and play back the movements of up to 8 servos at once. He also shows you how to create the controls you'll need to puppet the mouth movements or eye blinks, head movement, and eye movement. I love this stuff. It's like Disney Imagineering 101, and I'm excited to see more videos from Jim. Finally, this past Monday, I had the chance to catch up with Becky Stern and talk to her about her social stats tracker display. It was a great talk, and I learned about the cheap, awesome Node MCU board she used for her project. You can find the video of our talk on my channel, and I'll also link to it at the end here. And if you ever want to catch these talks live and ask questions, be sure to hit that notification bell down by the subscribe button. Maker Faires! Man, there was a dry spell there for a while, but there are a ton happening this weekend. You've got Dubai, Nuremberg, Germany, Palm Bay, Florida, Denton, Texas, Kalispell, Montana, Windsor, Ontario, and Gainesville, Florida. If one of those are near you, don't miss a chance to mingle with your people and get inspired. Boop! And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave me a thumbs up, leave me a comment, get on the email list, get yourself some 18650 rechargeable batteries if you can use them. And if you really like this show, you can buy me a coffee using the Buy Me a Coffee link right down here. I think that's been working out great, and I appreciate all of you who've been using it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.